नमस्कार गीता
नमस्कार।
महोदया, नवीन
नमस्कार
महोदय।
नमस्कार गीता महोदया महोदया
नमस्कारम
नमस्कार।
महोदय।
अहं ना शृणोति अंशु महोदय आचार्य महोदय अहं भवतः
ओ यू कैन नॉट हियर मी। लेट मी सी,
आम नाउ आई कैन
यू कैन हियर?
नाउ
ओके,
वी कैन
परफेक्ट
वी
परफेक्ट।
कैन
नमो नमः वैभवी जी।
नमो नमः आचार्य।
नमो नमः वैभवी जी।
दीर्घ कालम अस्ति
कुत्र अस्ति
कोविड ड्यूटी।
ओ नवीनजी, योर वॉइस वॉज ब्रेकिंग। इज इट आर
बहु
यू
धन्यवाद। आई वॉज गोइंग टू से आई वॉज ट्राइंग टू से लाइक मेनी थैंक्स फॉर योर सेवा।
ओ करेक्ट करेक्ट, सेवा परमो धर्म। वैभवी जी इज प्लेइंग हर इम्पोर्टेंट रोल।
Everybody's role is important, Anna.
हाँ, दैट इज वाई वी आर गिविंग यू धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू धन्यवाद।
कोविड वॉरियर,
कोविड वॉरियर, संस्कृत वॉरियर, स्ट्रिंग वॉरियर, सो मच।
I want to do more for string, but now I'm in quarantine, after quarantine.
Oh.
After every duty, it is compulsory. Quarantine.
Okay. But even from home, you can do a lot, like we are doing right now.
What?
Just attending Sanskrit class, that itself is a big
thing. It was like different time, different days. It used to be on rotation. So now I'm in quarantine. Now I can attend.
Correct. And are you into content?
What, Anna?
Are you into content research or that side also? At string?
No. Actually, I was just called in to make things fast because many people were not were like kind of lethargic or didn't know where to go or something, and I was also assigned the task of finding some content writers for English.
Right.
So I was with that. Now there are enough content writers, they say. So right now there is no active role I'm playing with string.
Okay. Yeah, it is all time. I think it is all timing that when you were called, that was the necessity. Now you were needed for COVID war.
Yeah.
So by that time, content writers are enough here. नमो नमः हेमंत महोदय एंड महा महोदय।
सर्वे नमो नमः।
नमो नमः।
ओके वी वांट टू सी एवरीवन। सो हेमंत जी ऑलरेडी डिड अ गुड थिंग बाय डिस्प्लेइंग हिमसेल्फ इन द नाइस संडे कलर ऑरेंज। वी वांट टू सी एवरीवन। सो गीता जी नवीन जी वैभवी महोदय एंड मोहम।
कैन यू सी मी और इज इट नॉट शोइंग?
नॉट येट। वैभवी जी यू लुक फाइन।
Actually, anybody is now contributing for string or is still existing? I didn't know.
Yeah,
it is still existing.
But I'm not into it at all. It's become 1 month now. I don't have any work or nobody. No, nothing.
Which groups were you a part of?
I was with Varun Anna and all that.
Varun Anna for what?
Culture
and art. Okay, I'll talk to Varun. We can pass on the message, because if somebody is interested and he or she is not getting added to the groups again, because recently there have been some changes, right? So you might be aware. I'll pass
yeah,
on
I know.
To him.
Yes.
And we'll figure it out, no problem. So Naveen ji, you are still not visible. Moha ji also, and Vaibhavi ji also disappeared. Oh, now
Sarvesham namo namaha. Sarvesham namo namaha.
Namo namaha.
Namo namaha.
My laptop is super slow today. Sorry, I guess my internet and laptop, both of them.
Oh no, but we can hear you fine. So it's fine.
Yeah, I think it's settling down now. That's the reason I could not log in. Took 12 minutes for me to log in.
So do you start your laptop when you log in, or is it just
sitting? No, it was already on, but I think it was hibernating.
Okay.
Geetaka, you're looking so pretty. See, we both are wearing blue. We should decide and wear the same color, all of us, next week.
Okay.
I have been thinking about it since the time we came.
I and Hemant
are similar. Red and orange.
So I was actually talking about that, the Sunday color. So if you observe, I am always red on the Sundays, because we meet on Sundays.
Surya. And, Surya.
And yes, it is all color coded on every day for me. For many
so Monday
years,
is what?
More than 10 years now.
What is Monday?
Monday is Somvar, right? So Som is the Chandrama.
White.
Chandrama,
white.
Correct. So white color.
Mangalwar red again.
Mangal red.
Budhwar green.
Budhwar green, perfect. See, you know everything.
Yellow. Thursday yellow.
Thursday comes yellow. So then how
Friday
come you are in blue today? It is.
My life mein aap kabhi bhi mujhe red ya yellow mein nahi pehne. Like warm colors mein pehni nahi sakti ho. Never.
Oh. Okay. You know what happened with warm colors? You are already warm, that's why, or
exactly. Okay. Seriously, मुझे सहन नहीं होता है. I cannot.
Okay. Interesting. Okay, so let's do a quick aum first, and then we have a lot to talk about today. We will talk about colors as well by days. Then we have to talk about vibhaktis, and sometimes I feel 1 hour is too less. And
exactly,
we'll try as much as possible, maybe till 8:30 or if
everything. I have to sorry actually I have to leave at around 8:10, 8:15 maximum. I have to
Okay. We'll see. Whatever, as long as everybody is able to attend and everybody is available, we'll try. All right. So, the Aum Sadhana. Let's close our eyes. And I think Vaibhavi ji might. Oh, one more person is joining. Who is this? Naveen
ji. No.
Okay, maybe it was his laptop versus mobile. Okay, he'll figure it out. I think he is able to hear us. Okay, close your eyes and you can follow me on the Aum Ucharan. We'll do it for a minute. All right, you can open your eyes. Do you actually feel the energy moving from around your navel towards your neck and the head when you go with the out?
Vibration in the head. Remains, the more sound remains in the head.
Correct. So let me share that page which we use every week, and I'll show you a picture. I will make a picture. I think we made something last week also. So I will use that to describe for a minute and then we'll continue.
Acharya Mahoday, I sent you Dheya Mantra.
Right now. Thank you. So Naveen, you are sending me something right now, or you were talking about something before?
No, I already sent you to your WhatsApp. I sent you the dhyaya, Sanskritam dhyaya mantra.
Okay. Let me see. It's on our group message.
No, directly to
Correct. This is actually nice. This is in one of the Sanskrit Bharati books also. I have not one, actually, I have seen it in multiple Sanskrit Bharati publications. And I know that your daughter is going through with courses with them. So, yeah, that is nice. I think even I have more than 20 different publications of Sanskrit Bharati at home. And I sent a picture also, if you remember, last week. This one.
इनफैक्ट मैं वही पूछने वाली थी, वो संस्कृत भारती की थी पुस्तकें जो आपने मंगाई थी?
हाँ,
हाँ
ऑल ऑफ देम।
ओ वंडरफुल।
मैसेज में मैंने लिखा, आई रोट दैट इन द मैसेज आल्सो ना, सौजन्य पर संस्कृत भारती।
शायद मैंने नहीं पढ़ा, बट आई सॉ द कलेक्शन।
हाँ,
या इवन आई सॉ
एंड दैट इज हाफ ऑफ द कलेक्शन, दैट वाज ओके। सो इफ लेट अस सी, सो नवीन जी, व्हाट डू यू नॉर्मली डू? इट इज दिस अवेलेबल टू यू एज अ पोस्टर, और इज दिस अवेलेबल टू यू एज आई कैन राइट इट डाउन ऑन द स्क्रीन फॉर यू सो दैट वी कैन ऑल।
Or you, I, if you want, you can just copy and paste it also, right?
हाँ, वी कैन डू दैट, लेट्स ट्राई दैट।
But this is, I don't know this for sure, but they say this is copyrighted by Samskrita Bharati. That is a good thing actually. To stop others, others meaning in the sense you know who I'm saying others here. So to misuse it, they may misuse it, especially in the US. So they have copyrighted it, but I don't think they have any restriction for us to use it. We can use it, we just don't, like, we should. To like others without their permission or something like that. But we can use it in the class. There is nobody stopping us from reciting it.
Yeah, actually, Sanskrit Bharati's aim is also to help educate as many people, right? So it's always a two-sided thing that what you used to learn, somebody else can misuse. So it's so we'll not worry too much about it. But yeah, it's a good thing once I have bought a book or you have bought a book, you will learn from it. So there is nothing like you will not be able to talk to others about it. Main thing is what they probably say, that you don't copy that page from the book or like publish that directly somewhere. But you have, if you have learnt that shlok and then you are telling somebody, it's okay. Okay.
And actually, Mohawk also had shared one Sanskrit channel, you know, where they teach Sanskrit through Bhagavad Gita and the shlokas. That channel is also very, they have a lot of information.
Was
After
that
he
from
sent it,
Sanskrit
I just
Bharati?
tried to research and see more of their episodes, you know. Lot of information about Sanskrit is there in that channel.
आपने वो पूरा देखा गीता का? You have been following the channel now?
No, I just after you sent that, I just researched as to who that person is and what is he teaching. There are a lot of episodes teaching about Sanskrit.
Yes.
Simple, then advanced, like that. You know, beginners, they teach like that. It's very nice.
Yeah.
Right. So then you should also teach us back in our class whatever you learn there. So that we can all share.
I just saw it. I found it very interesting. I just saw it. It was like, you know, very nicely they were teaching through the shlokas and the Bhagavad Gita chapters. Using those chapters, they're trying to teach Sanskrit. It's very nice.
And I think it is Sanskrit Bharati only. As long as I remember. Because Sanskrit Bharati has this going on, which says learn Gita through Sanskrit and Sanskrit through Gita. So it's both ways.
Okay.
And just additional information is that every day in SVBC channel, SVBC is Tirupati TTD channel, which they have, 5 to 6 in the evening, they teach Bhagavad Gita through stories. And Sanskrit is also covered, like, you know, they don't say specifically that they're covering Sanskrit, but it's obviously Sanskrit. But they're teaching Bhagavad Gita through stories.
Is it in Telugu? Because I get the channel, but I don't see it as such. Is it in Telugu?
You know, Telugu, yeah.
Oh.
You understand Telugu, I
at
think.
At least Naveenji can utilize
it. I do understand, Akka, but if it is spoken very rapidly, then I cannot.
It is chased Telugu only.
Mm-hmm.
But they are taking the Bhagavad Gita shlokas and they are teaching through stories.
I will try to. 5 to 6 every day in the evening, right?
5 to 6. And it comes in the morning also. The repeat program comes in the morning also.
Okay.
10 to 11 or 9 to 10, something like that.
So if you download the video, if there is a video that you can download of that, then you can reduce the speed in VLC player, Mohaji, and then watch.
Right.
That's just... Okay, let us start with this Dheya Mantram. So what we'll do is we'll pick the first part of it today and go through it. And it's very easy. I think each one of you will understand as we write it together. So pick your pen and paper or wherever you are normally writing during this class, and it starts with an Aum. Aum Pathami Sanskritam There are multiple schools of thought around this, whether when to use anuswar versus when to use the ma at the end. But we'll just follow one of them, which is a explicit half ma at the end, like in Sanskritam.
मुझे ना एक doubt है, अभी पूछूं मैं.
Let me just complete this line.
Okay.
And then, let us talk about it. Aum Pathami Sanskritam Nityam
Vadami Sanskritam
Sada Sanjeev Ji is missing today. Maybe he is watching IPL. IPL just started.
Yesterday, he and his wife, I think, Asha Akka, we both were not there in the class also. Friday class.
Who?
मैंने आज तक एक भी IPL नहीं देखा है लाइफ में.
Good that you are safe from the attraction
frenzy
of the world.
Attraction. Attraction is pulling him.
Many people find it like an attraction.
नहीं संजीव जी को इसे सुपरफिशियल मत बनाइए
आई होप ही इज नॉट इनटू दैट जस्ट ओके बट या यू वर आस्किंग समथिंग मोहन जी
मैं ये कह रही थी कि आज ये पुरुषोत्तम मास चल रहा है ना तो मैं 108 जो सहस्त्र नाम होता है विष्णु जी का उसका पाठ कर रही थी तो मेरे को एक डाउट आया क्योंकि कल जो श्लोक था जिसमें नमः कालाय था नमः कालाय लास्ट में जहां पे अपन ने रोका था कल श्लोक पे तो उन्होंने बोला था कि क डबल हो जाएगा और नमः हो जाएगा वो इट इज नॉट नमः तो जो 108 नाम आते हैं जस्ट एनीवन हैज आइडिया कि इज इट ओम विक्रमाय नमः कि ओम विक्रमाय नमः उसको प्रोनाउंस कैसे करेंगे
विक्रमाय नमः आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट यस्टरडेज क्लास और द विष्णु सहस्त्र नाम
नहीं नहीं वो तो ठीक है बट कल की जो क्लास में था ना जहां पे अपन ने रोका था इफ यू रिमेम्बर आई थिंक गीता जी आपने भी परसों वो अटेंड किया होगा राइट वो बुकलेट दे में बुकलेट हाँ तो यू माइट हैव स्टॉप्ड एट द सेम प्लेस ना नमः कालाय राइट गीता जी
शिवोपासना मंत्र शिवोपासना मंत्र
कुसुम अक्का ने बोला था कि इट इज नमः कालाय इट इज नॉट नमः राइट यू रिमेम्बर So now, if I don't know if you can see in this right now, ये दिखेगा क्या? So if you can see, it is Om, जो भी है, it is Namah. So अगर इसको Namah pronounce करते हैं या Namah होगा pronunciation में.
I think so. Both should be okay. But yesterday
was fine.
क्योंकि उन्होंने मेरे को ऐसे बोला था ना कल उन्होंने क्लास में अक्षु जी को भी याद होगा दिस इज व्हाट शी सेड नमः काल जब ये रोका था तब सो आई वाज कंफ्यूज्ड एक्चुअली सुबह जब पाठ कर रही थी तब
ओके नहीं इट्स नॉट टू डिफरेंट सो सी द वर्ड नमः इज अ कंप्लीट वर्ड नमः राइट बट व्हेन इट इज यूज्ड इन वर्सेस और इन श्लोक और मंत्र देन व्हाट कम्स आफ्टर इट affects how you pronounce it so the word is not changing but the pronunciation changes so if you let me think of another one you have heard of that yada yada hi dharmasya yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharat
bharato
No, I am not going up to Bharat there, but what I am trying to help you remember is this one. Glanir Bhavati Bharat. Now, this is actually a combination of two separate words. One is Glanih. Dhan Bhavati. And when the nih combines with bhavati and you make it a single word, then that visarga goes away and that visarga sound becomes a ra sound before bha. So that is why it becomes glanir bhavati.
It sandhi.
So it is a sandhi. So what Kusuma ji was talking about was not a pure sandhi but the namah sound is broken a little just because the next word is kalai so you have to say kalai quickly and to maintain the pace of the shlok the pace of the mantra also so that is why you say namah kalai otherwise you will normally say namah kalai that is also okay there is nothing wrong or right about it It's just that to
इसमें कैसे होगा जब नमः लास्ट में आता है इसमें कैसे होगा सपोज वैसे जब नमः लास्ट में आता है विष्णु अष्टोत्तर शतनाम में तो ये कैसे होगा ओम भगवते नमः होगा या ओम भगवते नमः होगा
यू आर एक्चुअली साउंडिंग सेम बोथ टाइम्स ऑलमोस्ट सो इट्स नॉट अ इशू
कम्स इन द लास्ट is most of the time it is Namaha.
Mohakai, if I can just add in. Yesterday, Bhismaka was teaching Vamadevaya. You've gone there? Vamadevaya. Have you gone till there?
Yeah.
Namo Jeshtaya and all that?
Yes, yes, Akka.
So, in that, you know, Namah Shreshtaya, that mom will become half. It becomes Namah Jeshtaya, that she told that way. In that, when the Namaha comes, it becomes half, and you say half of Ma. But when it comes in the end, it becomes Namaha.
Okay.
That's what even Acharya is telling, no? The same thing. Glani Bhavati Bharata. Glanihi, that na, Nihi becomes, it becomes a kind of a bridge. The Sandhi becomes, it adds on to the other word. And becomes a Glanir Bhavati Bharata. The same way it happens with Ma also. That's what I understood.
And what she is saying is, when it comes at the end, it can be pronounced as a full Namaha or Namaha, depending on the pace of your mantra or pace, or you would have sung songs and shloka, right? So you know how much time you have to spend on a whole line. So sometimes right. It is controlled by that, but there is no wrong or right about it. Namaha is Namaha. Now, how long you pronounce that ha depends on where it is.
Yeah, from childhood I've been hearing Nama Shivaya or Namaha. So that's how I've been hearing from childhood.
Namah Shivaya. So Namah Shivaya, we don't say the ha too much in Namah Shivaya, right? Because Shivaya is the next word.
Yeah. If it comes after Shivaya, it's Namaha, right? Shiva Namaha.
Correct. At the end, you will normally say a full ha separately, like Namo Namaha. When we say Namo Namaha, that is a full H sound. Okay. So did you get to write this? Pathami Sanskritam, Nityam Vadami Sanskritam Sada. Vyayami.
Vyayami.
Sanskritam
samyak.
Samyak vande sanskrit mataram. Nice.
The two parallel lines are given at the end of the shloka.
Correct. So when it is a small halt, that is a single line, and then double line means that's the end of the shloka.
So it's like comma and full stop.
Okay. So, is there anything to understand separately on this, or this is easy to understand, right? Pathami Sanskritam, Nityam Vadami Sanskritam Sada, Dhyayami Sanskritam, Samyak Vande Sanskrit Mataram. What do you Samyak for?
Yeah, samyak artham kim?
Samyak at this place. I have to. Yeah, yeah, me Sanskritam. Samyak Vande Sanskrit Mataram. Okay, let's discuss that in a minute. While we are.
Samyak means good, right? Does that, I don't know what in the, what here in this context, what it means, I don't know, but generally the word Samyak means good. Is that correct? Or?
Samyak in general means good.
I'm asking Acharya Mohoday, I'm not sure what Samyak means in general too. Like, and in this context too, I don't know what it means.
Samyak normally means together. So it's like including others or...
Oh.
Or... It has actually multiple meanings, together and completely.
Oh.
Every
as,
time.
As a group. So when you say Dhyayami Sanskritam, Samyak Vande Sanskrit Matram, so you are saying that we as a, like we citizens or we the people, Vande Sanskrit Matram. So we all do pranam to Sanskrit yeah. Mata. So you can say completely as a group. Or together. Okay. Now, while we are on shlok, let us learn a new one today, and I think some of you might know it, which is even better. And let us see if you can understand it. I think this will also be fine for you. Abhivadan. Shilasya. And you can write it down as well.
Bhavatah yavanikam.
Oh, mama yavanika pashyasi va?
Pashyami.
Idani.
Idinam. Idinam pashyami.
Idani.
Idanim pashyami.
Okay. Abba. Abhivadan shilasya. Nityam. Vriddhopasevinah Chattvari tasya vardhate Ayur Vidya Yashobalam. I'll add one here, and this is a book style. Writing. Did you all write down? Is this understandable? Vivadanshilasya. So somebody who is respectful, caring.
To the elders.
Elders.
To anybody. So that elders will come in a moment. Nityam vriddho pasevina. So nitya means daily or regularly. Vriddho pasevina, which means vriddho ki seva. So serving the elderly. So somebody who is respectful and daily he or she serves elders. Chatvari tasya vardante. So these four things of his or her. Tasya means his or her. And we have we used tasya before in our class? I don't think so. And
no.
I have written down in my notes also. We were going to study together today, but let's see if we reach there. Okay, so
chatvari. Comes in Gayatri
Mantra. Chatvari maine suna hua hai yoga mein, but mujhe, I'm trying to recollect, mujhe yaad nahi aa raha hai.
Four. Chatvari tasya vardante, which means these four things will increase for that person. Ayu, Vidya, Yash, Yash and Bal. So, Ayur, Vidya, Yashobalam.
Reminds Buddhir Balam Yashodhairiyam.
You may have to join again. This might, this will end in about 5 minutes.
3 minutes more.
So,
Abhivadanshilasya. Respectful.
Respectful.
Namaskar. Respectful namaskar ya sirf respect?
Respect is respect. Abhivadanshil.
Abhivadan is, matlab abhivadan karna na kisi ka. Namaste, namaskar.
So namaskar is a part of respect, but the emotion is respect, right? So it's not just the namaskar action only. Abhivadanshil means somebody who is respectful.
Shila means the soul, right? Shila means soul?
What, Gita ji?
Shila means soul.
Oh, shield means one of the virtues. Shield means proper characteristics. One of the virtues of a human being.
Character.
So if you want to say, for example, guna shield. So guna shield means somebody who has many, many gunas. Right? So abhivadan shield means somebody who possesses this virtue of abhivadan.
Okay.
So, any questions on this one, or this is understandable? And this is easy also. Abhivadan shilasya nityam vriddhopasevinah chatvari tasya vardhante ayurvidya yashobalam. So, can you, can each of you repeat it once? Let's start with Moha Mahodaya.
Abhivadan shilasya nityam vriddhopasevani. Sorry. Vruddhopasevinah chatvari tasya vardhante Ayurvidya Yasho Balam.
Perfect. Naveen Mohday.
Adivadana Shilasya Ruddho Chatwari. What is it? Tasya Chatwari Tasya Ruddhena
Vardante.
Vardante. Kshamyatam. Chatwari Tasya Ante Ayurvidya Yasho Balam.
Correct. Hemant Mahoday. Okay. So, if I am asking informally, then what I would say instead of saying Mama Nama Anshu, I would say Aham Anshu. Bhavan Kaha, Hemant Mahoday. So, that is a new expression, Bhavan. And I will write it for both. Bhavan is for males and Bhavati is for as the striling of the same.
Pulling.
So Bhavan is pulling, Bhavati is striling. So for pulling we will say Bhavan Kaha, or for striling you remember Ka. So Kaha or Ka means who are you? So you are just asking who are you?
Bhavan. Okay. Bhavan Kaha. Bhavat.
So Aham Anshu. Bhavan Kaha, Hemant Mahoday.
Aham Hemanta. Bhavan Kaha, Naveen Mahoday.
Aham Naveenaha. Bhavati Ka Gita Mahoday. Mahodaya.
Mama Gita.
Aham.
You can say Aham. Mama Gita means my Gita.
Aham Gita. Bhavati Ka Moha Mahodaya.
Aham Moha. Bhavati Ka Vaibhavi Mahodaya.
Aham Vaibhavi. Bhavatah Kaha Naveen Mahodayah.
Aham Naveenaha. Bhavan Kaha Anshu Mahoday.
Aham Anshu. Hemant Mahoday Sajjanah Va Naveen Mahoday.
Aham. Hemant Mahoday Sajjanah Va.
Gita Mahodaya Dushtah Va Moha Mahodaya.
No.
So I am waiting for Moha Mahodaya to answer.
You asked her, right?
See, so she answered. I asked Gita Mahodaya Dushtah Va Moha Mahodaya. So I am asking you.
Actually, Gita Mahodaya. Okay. I got it. I thought you were asking her. Bhavati Gita Mahodaya. will it be Sajjan itself for Streelink? No, right?
That is fine. So Sajjana, you can say Sajjana, but first you have to answer my question. So you will probably say Na Gita no. Mahodaya Dushta Na, or you can say Aam Gita Mahodaya Dushta, whatever you want to answer.
No, I was saying she is Sajjan, is what I'm saying.
So you will say Na Gita Mahodaya Dushta Na Gita Mahodaya Sajjana. Or you can just say Gita Mahodaya Sajjana. That is also enough.
But it is Sajjana, Streelink or Pulling.
Naveen,
so when you were saying, so when we person to we say Uttaram.
Your voice was breaking now.
Answer, how do we say that question?
Oh, there is so much of disturbance. One second. Let me mute everybody. Yes, Naveen was there. Now,
how do we ask, how do we say, answer the question? Please answer the question in Sanskrit.
Okay. Did Mohaji not answer?
No, she did, but like instead of saying it in asking it in English, answer the question. Uttaram vadatu, how do we say?
Uttaram vadatu is fine.
Rupiya uttaram vadatu, is that correct?
Uttaram vadatu or uttaram dadatu.
Okay.
Give me an answer or speak an answer, anything is fine.
Astu.
Or you astu. Can say Tava Uttaram. So your answer, which is a little informal, but there are multiple ways of asking.
Astu. Dhanyavadaha Acharya Mahodaya.
Okay, Moha Mahodaya, your chance to make somebody Sajjan or Dusht.
Hemant Mahode, Sanjeev Mahode, Dushta Va.
Dushta Va.
So for Dushta, we have the two forms, Dushta and Dushta. So when you answer, you will say Gita Mahodaya Dushta.
No. But is now, opposite Dushta or Durjan? Because Sajjan ka Hindi mein to Durjan hota hai na.
Correct. Durjan is in Sanskrit also. I just picked Dushta as a random word. It's not
really generic word. Okay.
Not really chosen as an opposite. So what was I saying? So, what do you understand with this word? Actually, I should put a whistle here and remove the halant. What is Upanama?
Nickname.
Okay, so now I will ask you other questions and I think you will be able to understand what we are talking about. Hemant Mahode, kasya naam, तस्य उपनाम गांधी
मोहन मोहा महोदय.
So you would say मोहा महोदया महोदयाः. So for आकारांत स्त्रीलिंग शब्द, do you notice that it is mahodaya is an akarant shabd and that is a striling shabd?
Yes sir.
Right, so for akarant striling shabd the shashti, because shashti vibhakti is the tasya kasya means of the mahodaya, of that person. And we are going to cover the vibhaktis today, so that's why I'm introducing you to that. Kasya, tasya, this is all of these words are shashti vibhakti. So where did we write tasya? I think that was on the last page. Chatvari tasya vardante. So tasya is also shashti. Do you notice this? Ramasya, Sanskritasya. Similar to that, tasya means his or her, which means of him or of her. So, not his or her, actually his or hers, because her is a different word. So, moha mahodaya. Now, if you wanted to ask the same thing for a male, a pulling, let us, you can ask the question to somebody, maybe Naveen Mahodaya, or just ask Geeta Mahodaya, maybe.
I forgot the question.
Okay, I will write the question. Kasya. Ask kasya upanamah Gandhi. So now you can pick somebody else's upanamah. And use that in your question.
Kasya upanamah Drona Wali Geeta ji?
No.
Kasya means whose.
Who's.
So Hemantji is asking whose upanama is Dronavalli.
Naveen Mahodaya.
Mahodayasya.
Mahodasya upanamaha Dronavalli.
So now do you notice that if the word is akarant pulling, see mahodaya is an ending in a, right? It doesn't end in a, it is a hrisva swar. So it is an akarant pulling shabd. And that is why the vibhakti, the shashti vibhakti is the normal ramasya, sanskritasya, vrikshasya, like that. But mahodaya is an akarant and that too striling shabd. So that is why shashti is a little different. So now I will write what Geeta ji just answered. Naveen mahodayasya upanamah. Dronavalli. Mm-hmm. and sometimes you can end with asti. Lot of times you, it's not even necessary. Asti is usually understood in a lot of usable Sanskrit. So do you notice the difference, everybody? The shashti, yes, for akarant pulling shabd is mahodayasya, ramasya, vrikshasya, sanskritasya. But for akarant striling shabd, it is slightly different. Mahodayayaha. I will give you an easier word so that it is easier to understand. So if you want to say of Gitaji, right? So you would say Gita Yaha. So the word, and then at the end you add a Yaha, and that completes the Shashti for Akarant Striling Shabd or Moha Yaha. Now Vaibhavi ji is a very slight exception, but it's not a very different one. So if a Striling word ends in E, so this is a Ikarant Striling Shabd. So then what you would say of Vaibhavi is Vaibhavyaha. So the ending E changes into Vyaha, means half of the last letter and then Yaha.
Goes away.
So I'll give you another example. If you have Nartaki and you want to say something of the Nartaki, so what would you write?
Nartakyaha.
Correct. So Nartakyaha. So you just half the last letter and add a Yaha. Is that understandable?
Acharya Mahan.
And I think some of you are writing it down also. So yeah, I will give you that a little bit of time.
I learned a few more padan yesterday.
Oh, so what was that?
Atra tatra sarvatra anyatra.
Nice. Atra tatra, have we used it before in our class? We have used for the books, right? We said Pustakam matra asti and Sadguru kutra asti.
We used atra tatra, yeah.
So Moha Mahodaya, Vayu kutra asti?
Acharya Mahodaya, Vayu sarvatra asti.
Uttamam.
Okay, now you can ask something.
Gita Mahodaya, Nadi Kutra Asti. Wait, I'll rephrase it. Sorry. Gita Mahodaya, Krishna Nadi. Krishna Nadi Kutra Asti.
Krishna Nadi Kutra Pradeshe Asti.
But will it be Krishna, first of all? इसलिए मैंने रिफ्रेस किया
कृष्णा
You can change in the Nadi, because if you want to change any Vibhaktis, you can change in Nadi, but right now it's a simple, there is the river, so Nadi will remain Nadi.
Nadi Anya.
So if you just say Nadi Kutra Asti, then you might say Nadi Anyatra Asti, because there is no specific name for Nadi. And now if you asked Krishna Nadi Kutra Asti, then what did Gita Mahadeva say?
Telangana Pradesh Krishna Nadi Asti.
Lot of noise.
I think somebody is moving a lot here and there.
And what is the actual meaning of Anyatra? Everywhere.
Everywhere is Sarvatra.
Huh.
Because Vayu Sarvatra Asti, right?
Huh.
So Anyatra is somewhere. What is Anya?
Elsewhere,
that is a single word for that, which is the same thing.
So if you want to say Kaveri Nadi,
Karnataka
Pradesh, Janma Asti.
Say that again.
Udgam, Gita ji, Udgam.
Udgam. So Kaveri Nadyaha. Or if you do not want to mention Nadi separately, and whenever you say Kaveri, it always means the Kaveri river. So you can also say Kaveryaha. Which means of Kaveri, or I would prefer to say Kaveri Nadyaha, so that it is exact that we are talking about the Nadi. So Kaveri Nadyaha Udgamam. Udgams. Hello. I think we have to use. You wanted to say Karnataka Pradesh?
Huh.
Karnatak Pradesh Asti.
Asti. Uttam. Kaveri Nadyaha.
So either Kaveryaha or Kaveri Nadyaha, both are okay.
If the other person already knows that we are talking in the context of Nadi, then we can say Kaveryaha. If you don't know,
मुझे नहीं समझ में आया कावेरी कावेरिया.
See, what are we using of कावेरी? So कावेरी नदी का उद्गम स्थल कर्नाटक प्रदेश है अस्ति, correct? So you can,
okay.
You just saw on the previous page, right? This. So you have a vaibhavi, so a word ending in E, then
E, okay.
We half the last letter and then add a yaha to it.
Okay.
Correct. So for Kaveri, you can say Kaveri Yaha.
So Kaveri Yaha. So Kaveri Yaha hi correct hai na? Kaveri nahi kehna chahiye na fir us samay.
Nadi.
In this word here, you are using the vibhakti for Nadi directly, right? So then you can keep Kaveri normal. So you will use either this or this. either Kaveri Nadiyaha or Kaveryaha.
Kaveryaha Nadi.
No, when you say Kaveryaha, then you are not using Nadi at all anywhere. If you want to use Nadi, then better use Kaveri Nadi. So this is a complete phrase together, Kaveri Nadyaha. Which one? Thalaha is pulling. There are a lot of Sanskrit words which are pulling, which are understood as napunsakling in many other languages. So, for example, Vrikshaha. So, Vrikshaha is a napunsakling in Hindi and even I think English also. But Vrikshaha is a pulling shabd in Sanskrit.
Okay.
So, similarly, Pustakam. So, Pustakam is a napunsakling in Sanskrit. So, and as we go along, as we read through some of the books which we have around, we keep figuring out which word is what. Pushpam, Phalam. So, whatever ends in ma is usually a napunsakling. And whatever is ending in a visarg, Vrikshaha, Sanskritaha, Manushyaha, are pulling shabd. So we learnt about anyatra, kutra, upanetram kutra asti.
Upanetram tatra asti.
अत्र उपनेत्रम अस्ति हेमंत जी आई शुड मेक इट अ बेटर क्वेश्चन अत्र उपनेत्रम अस्ति वा हेमंत महोदय
उपनेत्रम अस्ति
ओके कति उपनेत्रम अस्ति नाउ लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस अ न्यू वर्ड
अति Sundaram.
Okay, kati means how many.
Oh, I thought ekam. Ekam upanetram asti.
Ekam. Eka.
Ekam. Ekam is.
Ekam.
Ekam. Because you are qualifying upanetram, right? So if, let's say this was a vriksha, so I was asking you, kati vrikshaha asti. So vrikshaha is a pulling, so that, then you would say ekaha vrikshaha.
Okay.
But here it is upanetram, which is a napunsakling, so you will say ekam upanetram. So the count of, and I think we have done this before, the adjectives, visheshan, changes its vibhakti according to the word it is describing. Okay, I will keep the upanetram. Upanetram tishthami. Tishthami is a little wrong usage, but I am still using it as a joke. Tishthami means, have we used it before, tishthati or tishthami?
Tishthati, I think we used tishthati.
Rita Mahodaya, Maha Mahodaya, tishthati va?
Tishtati is like part, right? Or sitting.
Sitting. Or sitting. Parked.
Park.
So it is lying somewhere or it is, in terms of human beings, we say sitting.
Sitting.
If you use for objects like pustakam or things like that, then you will say park. You will use it for lying or parked somewhere. Okay, now there was one word which we learned slightly differently. So I have to cover it once more to clarify. So let me write it here and let's see if you remember it from the last class. And for some of you, if it is new, even you might try to understand and we can discuss. Pachakaha. Pachati. What is this?
Pachaka is glass.
No, I might ask you, Gita ji, right now. Gita Mahodaya, Hemant Mahodaya Pachati va?
Cooking.
Pachaka is a cook and Pachati is cooking.
Na Acharya, Moha Mahodaya, Samskrutasya, Samskrutam Patasi,
Patati. Patasi is when you are directly talking to Mohaji, but you are talking to me, right? So Mohaji is a third person right now. So you will use Patati.
Patati.
Okay, try on somebody else the same question or
Hemant Mahodaya Vaibhavi Mahodaya Pachaka Pachati Va
Na Vaibhavi Mahodaya Na Pachati.
You can say some other term also.
Okay, what were you saying? You can say something else. So, Vaibhavi Mahodaya Na Pachati, Vaibhavi Mahodaya Tishtati. So it's like normal talking. So you are just saying she's not cooking, but whatever she is doing, you can say that as well. Okay, pass it on, Hemant Mahodaya.
Geeta Mahodaya, Tatishtati va Vaibhavi Mahodaya.
I didn't hear you. Can you please repeat?
Geeta Mahodaya Tishthati va.
Geeta Mahodaya. So Geeta Mahodaya Tishthati. Did you hear me, Acharya?
Keep asking. Keep asking.
Okay. SS, who is SS? Geeta Mahodaya is it? Okay. Naveen Mahodaya Tishtati va Moha Mahodaya.
Aam Vaibhavi Mahodaya, Naveen Mahode, Tishthati Va.
Tishthati.
Tishthati, that's it.
Tishthati.
So this is what we have to get used to, that when you say va, it actually becomes a question. So when you answer, you have to remember to remove the va. Because
what was the word? Uptishtati.
What was that, Hemant Mahoday?
What was the word for standing?
Uttishtati.
Uttishtati. So we will write that as well.
Get up, Nona.
Get up is uttishtha. So when you want to say uttishtatu, yeah, or you want to command, imperative, so then you will say uttishtatu or upavishatu. But if you just say uttishtati,
so uttishtati is getting up, or is it standing position? Is it like getting up? Is it the action of getting up, or is it the action of standing?
The action of getting up.
Action of getting up. Okay. Dhanyavad.
So actually, when you just say tishthati, tishthati can be used for even standing. So tishthati simply means you are there somewhere, you are parked somewhere. So thanks Vaibhaviji for bringing that up. Uttishthati versus upavishati. So upavishati is sitting. Upavish is sitting. So that is
that.
Sitting, I have to remove that sitting from the other place. Let us say that as parked. Parked is better there.
Samskrita Bharati Upavishati Upayoga Upayoga Karoti.
Karoti, correct, okay. Parked or lying.
Present. It is present there. It is there.
Or it's there, huh? It's just there.
Present.
So just use it in a sentence, Vaibhaviji, and then people will understand, get it more. Maybe you can show something.
Which one now?
Tishthati.
Takam tatra tishthati.
Acharya mama kaksha. I have to leave and go. I didn't know what to say.
Agachami. Last class we discussed, right? Agachami means I will come. So.
I want to leave the class.
Yeah, so you never say I am going. You always say I will come back.
Okay.
It's just a Vastu thing. So
even in Telugu and other many language, we will say we will.
Correct.
It's just a Vastu thing, and it's a ominous way of saying that you are leaving. So yeah, we can stop. We are actually already 8:30. All right, so kaksha samaptam karomi.
Dhanyavadah acharya.
Shubharatri and sarvesham namaha.
Sarvesham
namo namaha. Namaste.